Hello there, everybody, it's iGoDZoFLuiGii and welcome back to some awesome Pokemon World Online. In the last episode, we kind of got a bit done around in Celadon City, well, basically exploring wise, but today we'll be taking on our fourth gym leader of the Kanto region. Yes, that is right, the gym leader is a grass type Pokemon, so you want to bring either a fire or a bird type Pokemon with you for the great advantage point on this. If you start off a Charmander, then you will face this with ease. We can talk to the gym tips guys. Hello, hello, tough guy. Train hard before taking on the next gym. If you lose and you're from Johto, you have to wait 24 hours from here on out. If you're from Kanto, it's a little easier, just an 8-hour wait. So we only have to wait eight hours if we lose, but luckily I'm confident with my team. So let's show off my team. We've got a Growlithe now at level 29. We caught that off screen. That was pretty good. We got my Pidgeotto, which is level 40. My Dodrio, which is level 33. My Venusaur, level 41. Gyarados, level 40. And Butterfree, level 42. So that is even better. Again, like I said, I was training these off-screen, so they may look a bit stronger. So let's talk to the door woman and let's see what she has to say. I'm mispronouncing my words today, and I truly am sorry for that. I don't know, I just come back from work not that long ago, and I just wanted a break before I done this video. You had the Thunder Badge, you may enter. So you have to have the previous badge in order to enter this gym in the correct sense. Now, in every gym, there will be a guy at the door called Gym Walkthrough. Basically, he will help you out on your travels. Basically, if you're stuck in the gym and you don't know about it, this is for rookie players out there. Okay, there's nothing wrong about being a rookie. I kind of find it pretty cool, actually, that are new people just playing Pokemon. So it's good for us to help each other out. So we meet again, trainer. Do you want to check my gym tips? Well, yes, I do, for all you new people out there. Be aware that Erika's favourite type is grass. I might have said her name wrong, but I call her Erika. Grass Pokemon are weak against bug, fire, flying, ice, and poison type Pokemon. Now, I did say flying type because those are most common, but I have a bug type here, Butterfree, so I even have that as well as my advantage. I can even use Venusaur, but it's just a grass, so it wouldn't do any effect. And the other two Pokemon just as reserves, so I should be even out for this one. If you want to resist grass attacks, you should use bug, dragon, fire, flying, grass, and poison type Pokemon. In addition, lots of the grass type Pokemon are also poison type, so avoid using a lot of bug and grass type Pokemon. If you were not aware, you are able to catch a Abra and evolve to Caterpie near Cerulean City to counter poison counterpart. If your starter Pokemon is Squirtle, you'll have issues in this gym. Also, if you obtain a Crobat, when I told you to for Cerulean City, it can aid you against this gym. Remember, if you lose against Erika, you will won't be able to battle her for a few hours. Good luck. Okay, now luckily I took some of the advice into consideration. I never called it Abra, mind you, because I just really hated it. So I'm using my Growlithe first on these NPC trainers. So let's go ahead with Amora Girl Casey. Let's see what she's got to give us. And by the way, I did actually bring some super potions with me, so I should be all set either way. Let me just close my bag down. And she has an Execute, okay? A Pokemon that you can get from the Safari Zone, if my knowledge is still correct on this game. I believe it is from Safari Zone, yeah. That's the only way I encountered it. And we use Flame Rail, her Fire Fang now. Let's do it on that. Two hits should do it. I'm a bit disappointed that I can't get it on one shot. I am poisoned, god damn it, out of the bat. I didn't actually really want that to happen. But either way, I got to level 30 now. That's pretty good. Six more. I think it's six more levels and I get my next move. I think it's 38. No, 36 or 38. Let's just double check that. 39, actually. I'm always one off when I'm to the closest number. Okay. That would be good. I got told to get all my levels before I evolve into Arcanine for some strange reason. Okay, let's go take on this other girl, Monica. Let's see what she has to offer us. I love grass Pokemon because they are delicate and beautiful. That is true, grass type Pokemon do have that delicate essence in them. And that's my dog. Well, yes. This is really happening in the recording. I have my door closed, that's probably why. Yes, I'll be with you in a minute, Paws. Dog's name's Paws, so... Yes, I'm still here. Oh, God. It's just going to keep doing that. So I'm going to end up calling off and I'll rejoin you. 2 sec. Okay, I am back. Sorry about that. Just sorted out the situation. That was the first time that ever happened on one of my recordings. So let's finish this Pokemon off as a Tentacle. We're still in the same trainer as last time. There was no massive gym cut at all. It's just an end recording and restarted again. So you missed absolutely nothing at all. Let's use Fire Fang and we can actually... Well, I'm no longer Monk AFK. If I'm AFK too long, I will get logged out. And I think you can get temporary ban. I'm not quite sure. But people try and just be AFK till they can, like... get their time up. I don't know, it's pretty weird. Yu-Gang, yes, I gain a lot of money from that, and I'm going to have to Flame Burst. Wow, I've kind of missed that. Growlithe is on a Flame Burst. Probably gonna get rid of Odasif. Okay, it's learning a lot of fire type moves. Was it on the chart? Oh yeah, it was. Wow, Flame Burst. I missed that. I am very sorry, I forgot to point that out. Okay, let's go into my backpack and use Super Potion on my Growlithe. And do I have any items to cure it? No, I don't. I have absolutely nothing on me. Wow. Let's take on Isabel, because why not? And we go back around and take on this trainer. We got Erika there that is just standing in the opposite direction. And we can see a Vulpix there. That's pretty good. That's her main Pokemon, if you couldn't tell. So she's probably going to use that one last, but it'd be really good if you could use it straight out of the bat. I'm hoping to actually finish her with my actual Growlithe. So let's use Flame Burst. Whoa! One shot on that one. That was pretty good. And we're nearly up to level 32. That was pretty good on that Growlithe there. It's good that we're doing more damage now. The more better moves we learn, the more attack damage they do. Plus the attack that we know overall. So it's actually quite good. And I believe my Growlithe is okay for the stats. You can find better ones at other locations. But for now, I think my one's okay-ish. I would have liked it if it was a shiny, but either way, it's still going to be a good, reliable Pokemon. So let's end this Paris off, because I didn't like Paris anyway. Yeah, but I said it, folks. Yeah, but I said it. You can probably just look at me in disappointment, but I don't care. Okay, let's... Alyssa, let's take on her. And this will be the last NPC. Being a gym leader is not just about training, it's about showing love and respect for your Pokemon. That's why Erika is the best. So explain to me how Giovanni became a gym leader. Because he was the 8th gym leader of the Kanto region. He was the mob boss of the Kanto region. Patrick of the world, he actually run an own Team Rocket. An evil organization dedicated themselves to stealing and capturing Pokemon and selling them on the black market. So explain to me, if you're a gym leader, you gotta have love and care for Pokemon. How the hell did Giovanni even get in that picture? See, there is a way around the system. You just have cruel people. See, there's bullshit. Never believe the rules system because no one's like that. This trainer's got a Bulbasaur, which, to be honest... I kind of got used to my Venusaur now, but I'm still going to hate it. Because my point is exactly, grass types do not help out at all. My Venusaur knows shit moves. It will learn shitter moves as it levels up. It won't even learn any good moves from TMs because it's that rubbish. And all other grass types are exactly the same. They're good on the defense, but on the offense, it's pretty much annoying. They're good for causing status problems, but other than that, they're pretty much useless. My one's useless in all vocabularies because it literally knows nothing good worthwhile. It's got nothing to do good with status problems. It's got nothing to do on the attack. It's got... Has it? No, it's got worst defense ever. And worst special defense. So literally, I have the worst grass type in the world. So with that being said, let's take on our gym leader. Plume, plume! Okay, let's talk to Erika. I'm Erika of Celadon City. I have been in this gym for a long time. I am old, but when I smell the sweet scent of flowers, I feel young again. If you beat me, you'll receive the Rainbow Badge. Erika has chosen to battle you. She sent out her vial. She sends out her weeping bell. Because why not? And I will attack with my flame burst. With one shot, feeling awesome and posing in the background. Now she's trying to send out her second Pokemon, but what will it be? Oh, it's a Tangler. Never mind, this is going to be quite easy. Yeah, one shot again. Oh god, I may have to heal my Pokemon up in a minute because I am getting hurt by poison and that stuff does annoy me. Can she use another Pokemon? She sends out a Victory Bell. Basically, that's the evolved form of Weeping Bell. You have to use a Leaf Stone on it. Which is no match for me because I just completely took it down. I owned it. Okay, let's see what the next one is. I gained a lot of XP from that. Level 36! Okay, it sends out a Vileplume level 31. Now, this is the evolved form of Oddish. No, not Oddish. That's Oddish. What the hell was the evolved form after Oddish called? I have no idea, but that's the evolved, that's the third form of Oddish's. Where's the final evolution of Oddish's second form, okay? Have to use a Leaf Stone to get that. Let's use Flame Burst. Oh no! What have I done? It's super effective. It uses... Okay. And I am the greatest! Took her down, I got a takedown. No, because that recalls damage onto me. You'll be a real idiot to use that. Only if you want to end a match in a draw, which that has happened before. You are proving yourself worthy, young traveller. Here is the Rainbow Badge, you mighty Stug. Now, fuck off. Okay, let's leave the area. Oh, you can't go through these. I thought I was stuck for a bit, but no, you can't go through them. Those are actually objects. My bad, I thought they were just patches that you can walk free. So we now have four badges in the Kanto region, only four more left. So in the next episode, well, I'll go back in here because I got to talk to the gym leader. Yes, thank you. I'll go talk to the, oh for God's sake. Let me back in, creepy old woman. Gloom, that's the evolved form of Oddish. I knew it would come back to me. Congrats on beating the gym leader. Please take this as a reward of your accomplishments.
He gives us an escape rope. Oh my god.
I'm so lucky. I want to thank all my adorable fans.
So in the next episode, we will be exploring more. But, well, basically not of Celadon City. If I bring on the map here, we will be backtracking. We'll be backtracking from Celadon to Lavender Town again. And we will be going south. So we'll be exploring Route 12 to Route 13 to Route 14 and then Route 15. Making our way to Fuchsia City where our fifth badge is. And the reason why we can't go on Route 17 or that, because, well, you need a bike. And we don't have a bike. Unless they fix that, I'm going to double check that now, but that's basically what's going to happen. We're going to go the long way around because we don't have a bike, because it's just one of those things. You go through here, there's the door bit, you know, you want to go through here, but you can't. I can't let you pass unless you've shown me you've earned the Marsh Badge. Oh, okay, you guess you don't need a bike, you need the Marsh Badge, so I need the actual, wait, is the Marsh Badge the fifth? It's 5th or 6th, but we have to come back to that anyway. So, there's that. Let's go up here anyway, while we add some more time to the video, because why not? You know, I'm here, so I might as well do it. And look at all those bikers. Oh, so you can't go through there. Wow, I just wasted my entire time coming here. Why add that bit in? Might as well just do something to it, unless it's part of an event that's passed, probably. Who knows? I might use it for an event, but who knows? So anyway, that's the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I have a 37 Growlithe now on my travels, near level 40. We will be taking on route 12 again. Basically, this will be all water type. then a bit of bird and normal type Pokemon. So it's a bit of a mixture, which I'm going to be using my Venusaur for the water types. So I believe it's going to go pretty swell, actually. It's going to be a great turnout event. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you stay tuned, and I will see you next time, everybody. Remember to comment, rate, and subscribe. Booyah! Bigga bigga boo-sha!